Hi everyone, this is Mayank Kothari. Today in this video, we are going to discuss about the strategic financial management paper that was held on 17th of the November 2017 for Chennai people. It was due on 3rd November 2017, but due to some reason, it was postponed for the Chennai people and now held on 17th of the November. Now talking about both the papers, the one that was held for rest of the India on 3rd November and the one was held for Chennai on 17th of the November, the difficulty level was same. Both the papers were easy. Now, maximum marks were asked, like maximum question were asked from the institute's material only. So, those who have given the importance to the study material and the practice manual, they might have felt that the paper is easy. For rest of the people, it was quite difficult. If you would not have gone through the institute's material, you might have faced some difficulties while solving this paper. Now, if we talk about, like, if I have to choose one among the two, like on the 3rd November 2017 and 17th November 2017, the paper on 3rd November was quite easy as compared to today's paper. But there is a slight, like, very small difference between the difficulty level of both the paper. Now, let's discuss about how much marks actually has been asked from each chapter. The majority of the chapter I'm going to discuss, you can see that from the capital budgeting, 16 marks of the paper was asked. But from, like, if we talk about the 3rd November paper, capital budgeting was not given that much of the importance. But yes, rest of the three chapters that I'm going to discuss now actually were important in 3rd November paper also. So derivatives, 16 marks. We had an importance for the same subject, for the same chapter in 3rd November. Again, not to talk about, but Forex has always been an important chapter in every attempt. Not only Forex, we have mergers also, which should be given due importance also. So this is what all about the topmost four chapters that was asked today in the SFM paper. But, and if you talk about the rest of the chapter, it's like leasing decision, 5 marks, dividend decision, 5 marks, security analysis, 8, and factoring, 8 marks. These two chapters were missing on the 3rd November paper, but it was like the question have been asked today in the 17th November paper. Let's discuss about the rest of the analysis. 60% of the paper were from these four chapters, like capital budgeting, derivatives, forex, and mergers and acquisition. And around 82% of the paper was asked from institute's material. So those who have gone through the study material, practice manual, or like RTP and supplementary, they might have felt this paper as easy. You can get this PDF in the description part of the YouTube channel. That will help you for sure. Talking about the source of the paper, practice manual, 75% of the paper was from the practice manual. Study material, 12%, supplementary, sorry, there is 75 marks and the percentage is 63% only out of 120. Now, you might be looking for the answers of the questions that actually has been asked in today's paper. I have not prepared any suggested answers for that, but what I can help you with is I can give you the reference of the similar question in the institute's material. So you can go to the institute's material and check out if you have given a proper treatment. The only difference between the question that has been asked today and the question that you will see in the institute's material is the numbers, the figures. The figures will be changed. So obviously the answers will not match, but you can at least be sure about the treatment that you might have given today. So in this PDF itself, on the second page, you will find the same thing. You can see that in the first column, I have written the question number. In the second column, sub-question number is there. Marks, chapter name, source, and reference. See, you can see here. PM means the practice manual, RTP November 14. And in the end, you will find study material. So out of four, like, out of four questions of the theory, three are from the study material itself. So institute has tricked you that if you would not have studied from the institute study material, there would have been a difficulty solving, yeah, writing these theory questions. Not only this, in the third page you will find the comparison with the 3rd November SFM paper, like from which chapter how much marks has been asked. This is the comparison chapter wise And you will also find the comparison of both the papers, 3rd November and 17th November, like based on the source. So I have did a little bit of more research for the RTPs also, and I have included those here also, that from which RTP how many marks has been asked. The total will not match to 120 because I have taken a different basis, like I have gone through the entire RTP and searched for, okay, this question has been asked today in the paper on 3rd November or 17th November. So I picked up that and put that here in the table. So this analysis you can get as in a PDF format, in the description format, you will description, you will find the link. This is all about the today's paper. Just forget about if the paper was not good for you. Plan for the vacations. December is coming. Plan for the Christmas. Plan for the New Year. All the best. Bye-bye.